Michael Keaton back at it again, wearing the cape and cowl as Batman. Can you believe it? We're back. It's Into the Comic Verse, and this doesn't work. That's better. Welcome to Into the Comic Verse. I'm Ryan, right here on Nerdy Blurb TV, where we talk about comic book, superhero, movies, and news that comes with it. There's a lot of news and rumors and everything, and whether they be news or rumor, who cares? We're going to talk about them right here, just as we've done before. It's great to be back. Been a long time. Just because Avengers Endgame is over doesn't mean a lot of crazy news hasn't been happening, because trust me, it has been. First up, what the freak, Michael Keaton. I am so stoked. When I heard this news, I thought, this is how the DCEU comes back to life, if they were ever alive to begin with. I am stoked with this. I think this is one of the smartest moves that DC could have made. They made a great move. They've made several moves when it comes to Infinite on Crisis Earth with the Flash TV series and the Legends of Tomorrow and many of those great TV shows. Yet they didn't have the same caliber, ironically, in their films. They went too high, too fast. They went way too crazy with it. They needed to go simple. They needed something that people could rally around. And something as simple as Sam Jackson with an eye patch walking in saying, "Come join these Avengers, mother freaker, with me," did it with Iron Man. And who knows, maybe Michael Keaton can be that guy for the DCEU, or whatever we call it nowadays. I have no idea what's going on, but I do know that this is such a smart move, because so many things could happen. That not only means that, because why else would they get Keaton? Why would they get Keaton to come back if it wasn't because he is the Batman of old? He is old man Batman from a different timeline. This could mean so many different things. Multiple different timelines that also could be discussing the fact that that freaking Infinite Crisis on Infinite Earth, everything that's been happening on their TVs, is happening in their films as well. I mean, this could be great news. I'm really excited for it. I'm still wary, but I am excited for the fact that DC has finally embraced the weird. They've embraced what the fans really do want. They tried, but they tried to go too fast with it, and they ruined it. The cool thing about Michael Keaton is that he's going to be doing this in two different universes. Talk about a guy who is stretched thin. Michael Keaton keeping the Sony Spider-Man verse alive and straddling the DCEU. He is in Morbius that we've seen, and whenever that comes out, I'm going to be there. I'm going to see that. It's going to be so cool to see how he's straddling as the Vulture in the MCU and in the Sony-verse, how he's going to straddle the line between MCU and DCEU as a huge player in both. There have been people who have crossed over before, but nothing like this. Nothing as pivotal main characters. And I'm not saying that Keaton's going to be a main character in both of these, but he's a symbol for multiple different universes, multiple different timelines, or just crossovers in general. For both of these universes, I'm stoked. The man is underrated. He killed it as Batman. He was phenomenal in Birdman, and he is the Vulture. Like, he made the Vulture cool, because he never really was cool to begin with. He was just some crotchety old man, and yet Keaton brought a whole new light to it. I'm excited to see how old man Batman, and I'm not saying that that's who he is, but that makes sense to me right now. Old man Batman. I'm excited for this. What do you think? Comment down below. Let us know what you're thinking. What's going on in your head? What are your theories? We might dive into those more, but I just had to get this off my chest, say we're back, and that I can't wait to see Keaton get back into it. Subscribe, like, whatever. I'm out of here. Peace. Be left in the dust, unless I stuck by you. You're the sunflower. I think your love would be too much, or you'll be left in the dust, unless I stuck by you. Thank you guys so much for tuning in here today at Nerdy Blurb TV and checking out this video. Consider subscribing if you're into this kind of stuff, because we like to keep it nerdy here and interact with cool individuals such as yourself. Have a great day.